Today, I'll be talking about a topic that is both fascinating and alarming. It is the impact of artificial intelligence on our environment and its carbon footprint. Artificial intelligence, or AI, has revolutionized the world around us. Today, we use it on social media, online shopping, virtual assistants, search engines. It has had its impact on several fields, finance, healthcare, and it has the potential to solve some of humanity's biggest challenges, like poverty, disease. AI can be sustainable for the environment. Its use in precision farming can improve the yield of crops, thereby reducing the greenhouse gas emissions of agriculture. In autonomous vehicles, it can reduce the impact of automobiles on the environment. It can also be used to design smart grids and data centers that reduce the impact of our infrastructure on the environment. But AI comes at a cost that is hidden from all of us, a cost that has a direct implication on our environment. I'm talking about the carbon footprint of AI. Many of you may know that AI is not a green technology. In fact, it is quite the opposite. It is a very carbon-intensive technology. University of Massachusetts Amherst researchers found that training one large language model takes about 300,000 kilograms of carbon dioxide released into the environment. To put that into perspective, that is around 125 round-trip flights between New York and Beijing. And this is just one large language model. Today, companies train thousands of LLMs every single day. Imagine its impact on our environment. And it is not the fact that training an AI model releases energy into the environment. It is also the complex infrastructure that is used to get AI going. This includes data centers, devices, networks, sensors. Data centers are a collection of thousands of machines that deal with all the data that is used to train AI. They use up to 1% of the world's electricity. To operate efficiently, they need to be cooled. And for cooling, you have two options. You either use water for cooling or air conditioners. Water-based cooling has the potential to introduce pollutants into water resources. Air conditioners, as you may all know, release refrigerants into the environment. Now, this is the infrastructure of AI. Coming back to the devices that we use, on which AI applications run. These devices, like our smartphones, tablets, laptops, smart watches, are made of minerals that are rare earth metals, like lithium, cobalt, gold, and silver. Mining of these metals introduces soil erosion, deforestation, water pollution. So what can we do about AI? How can we make AI more sustainable for our environment? We need to take steps to do that at multiple levels, as individual users, as developers of technology, and as policymakers. As individual users, we need to be aware of our digital footprint. You'd be surprised to hear that an average human being exhales around 2 pounds of carbon dioxide into the environment every day. But our footprint on the environment is 100 pounds per day, out of which 4 pounds is the digital activity. That is 2 times as much as we exhale into the environment. Deleting unnecessary files or using applications that are better for the environment are a choice that we all can make. As developers of this technology, there are ways in which we can optimize the data that is used to train AI models. There is research that is ongoing that works on pruning and quantization techniques. In simple words, these are techniques that reduce the amount of data that is used to train an AI model and still give the best results. As developers, we can also rely on cloud computing features that are based off of green technologies. For example, Google Computing Platform's green computing feature, that is carbon intelligent computing, that schedules the workloads that are non-urgent to align with those periods of time in the day when there is low carbon electricity supply. As policymakers, we can establish and enforce guidelines for ethical AI. We can promote transparency and accountability in the reporting and auditing of the carbon footprint of our AI models. We can incentivize innovation in the fields of green research in AI. European Union's Green Deal aims to make Europe the first climate-neutral continent by the year 2050, and it includes strategies for digital transformation with green goals. These are just some of the ways in which we can make AI more sustainable. But for this to happen, we need to act fast, and we need to act together. The climate crisis is one of the most defining challenges of our time. AI has the potential to be the solution, but it can also be the problem. It is for us to decide which one it will be. Thank you.